I'm Melissa Muir. Welcome back for another Tool Time Tuesday. In this video, I'm going to be covering something that a lot of people have been asking a lot for. And I'm going to be showing you how to get a good final polish on your metal. So I'm going to be showing you how to take a ring that has been sand casted. And in this case, it wasn't the cleanest casting, but I'm going to show you how I clean this up to make it so that it looks like one that was absolutely perfect. Now in this case, I have a very rough ring. I've cut off the sprue, filed it down just ever so slightly, just so that it wouldn't hurt me or cut into me as I was getting the inside prepared. At this point, there is not an attachment for the inside of the ring. However, I have heard through the grapevine that something like that is coming. So we'll see a little bit more about that later. But you can see, like I said, it is a fairly rough casting and a rough cleanup job at this point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the flex diamond. So this is one that is very, very, very abrasive. Now this is diamond, so it does need to be used wet. So I do have my water tray right here with some water. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this full speed. I do want to moisten this a little, and you'll see this right there. So you will see that I will kind of dip into this, and you'll see right now I've got a bunch of silver in here because I've polished a couple of other rings. So let me show you really quickly this sage. Just gonna get this a little bit wet here, load it up with water. Also, I will be dipping the ring a little bit just to keep things cool. So at this point, I've taken down the sprue quite a bit, and I've also just gone along and really cleaned up the surface of this. You'll see that I still have a little bit of that sprue to take care of. But notice that it's all nice and even as far as the surface goes. So a couple things that I want to point out as I'm going through this, and again, this is just with this flex diamond, really, really coarse diamond, good for very good, you know, higher end grinding. Something that you could also do is some of the ceramic ones. But you want to actually make sure that you continue to move as you're doing this, and that's going to ensure that you have a better, more even surface. I'll show you here. And also, I am giving quite a bit of pressure as I push up against it. You want to support the ring or your piece with both hands. And at this point, you can kind of see that surface is very, very rough. You can kind of hear that. But it's not too rough because I was very even in the way that I've applied the pressure and the movement. So from here, I'm going to go to the 120 ceramic. So the 120 grit ceramic. I don't need to use water on this one. However, this is going to heat up. So I highly suggest you can create some of the finger cuts. And that is using the flex tape that comes with the kit. And the way to make these is in a different video. So I'm not going to go over that right now. However, they are reusable. So I just slip these babies back on, protect my fingers a little bit because things will really heat up with my ring. Don't be afraid to put a little bit of pressure on there because you want some for sure. Running this at full speed, I'm just going to go through and smooth things out. Make sure you're supporting your piece evenly and tightly. And you can see the difference here. It's much finer surface. Okay, and once you have your surface the way that you want it, then you can move down to the next item. So again, you can see now we've got a surface that's much smoother. Again, not entirely finished yet. But now we go down to the Scotch-Brite, the compressed Scotch-Brite. In this case, I've got a medium compressed Scotch-Brite that I'm using. just spreads everything like butter. You just watch all of those lines disappear. And see the nice surface on that? And you can see what's happening here. So again, there's the untouched area versus this with the Scotch-Brite. So in this case of this ring, I still have the rough casting surface that is left over, and I've not done anything to these edges yet, but I'm just going to use the compressed Scotch-Brite for this as well. On this case, because we do have it where it's kind of rippled, I am going to be using a little bit of the edge. So again, just be very careful. Make sure that you've got your ring supported as you go through this. You can see it's kind of taking care of that, just smoothing everything out. And add just a little bit of a pit right there, and this will smooth that out as well. See that? I'm very careful not to hold it in one spot. I don't want to end up in any flat spots. And at this point, I have a very even surface. It's nice and clean. I'll flip it over and do the same on the other side. You'll notice that I'm holding this here like this, but I'm also pushing up underneath with my finger just to make sure I have enough pressure up against this wheel. Okay. Again, just taking a look at everything, make sure everything is nice and even. And from here, we're ready to give it the final high polish finish. And we'll do that with our felt. So you can see my felt is actually very well worn, and you can see a lot of the silver and stuff that's in this, and that's totally fine at this point. But if you ever need to clean it out, you can actually run it and then just take something like one of your regular sandpaper ones, just kind of let it run a little bit right here just to make sure that it softens up, it doesn't have too much buildup into it. Again, I'm going to run this at high speed. This is the felt. Never use water with this compressed felt. We are going to use Ani's compound. I like to load this up, especially when I'm doing a ring and I'm taking it to that high gloss finish. You want to give it a nice bit of pressure here. And you should be able to easily see that polish come up there. And at this point, that is a mirror finish. Yes, there's the camera. Hello. It's that fast. Another thing that you want to keep in mind is when you are using this tool, don't drag off. The tendency is to kind of drag off when you're doing a polish, kind of like that. You want to avoid that. Think about how if you were using a regular polishing arbor, you would pull it down away from the wheel. You wouldn't just drag against the wheel. You want to do the same thing here. You want to just drop down. And there is our ring. At this point, if I wanted to, I could also come back in and polish up these edges. However, for the sake of just a little bit of contrast, I'm going to leave that on this ring so that the only part that is highly polished is that surface. So again, we went from our flex diamond, we went to the 120 grit, then the medium Scotch-Brite, and then finally we ended with the felt and polishing compound. So it's really not too bad with the Jewel tool. Hopefully you'll find that helpful and it answered some of your questions. If not, by all means, give me a call. Yep.